Dirksen here, at work. Not sure how long this video is going to be. Hopefully longer than yesterday's. Yeah, so I'll see you.
So I'm at middle school, playing a game. I'll show you guys here in a second. Pretty cool. Sorry I didn't, record on my lunch break. I got busy today. So yeah, I'm going to show you guys.
Skin rots away, body parts start falling off, like it's really nasty, and it can be contracted simply by touching other people. Now, thankfully, it's not a common thing around most of the world, but there are still parts of the world where leprosy still exists. So, yeah, he actually healed 10 lepers. Did you have something? It was the lepers? Ah, okay, well. So he did all these things. He fed the 5,000, he fed the 4,000, right? He's bringing people back to life. Like there's spark after spark after spark, and the spark should have started a fire in Judas' life, like it did for the rest of the disciples. The problem is, there was something that Judas loved even more than Jesus. You guys know what it was?
Money.
Money. The Bible sometimes refers to it as mammon. Mammon. It's actually the god of money. Is this mammon? No. These are pieces of silver. Not real silver. It's fake. Yeah, I know, right?
The pastor's salary.
So, Judas, and this is actually more than 30 pieces. Judas loved this stuff more than he loved Jesus. Now, here's the thing. Can this heal the sick?
No.
Can it raise the dead?
No.
Can it really? It can raise the people from the dead? Ah. So it can like take a guy who's completely blind and can make him see.
Yes. Not yet.
No.
No.
It can. So you're. It can pay for things, sure, but it can't cause miracles. It can't bring back people back from the dead. Can this save your soul?
No.
No. Not just because it's fake money. But for Judas, either he was distracted, maybe he just didn't care enough, I don't know. I mean, that's so hard to get into Judas' head and be like, how did you miss it? You had all the opportunity in the world. You wanted to be a part of this. Jesus called you and you went with him. So obviously there was something you saw that just drew you to him. But we see over and over again, Judas, when he had the opportunity to serve, Judas, when he had the opportunity to be a part of something awesome, instead chose his physical desires more than spiritual desires. Let's see if I can get this going again. I got to put action with lighter fuel in this. So, where's my lamp? So Jesus, he's got this fire. Don't worry. Smoke is not toxic. He's got the fire going. Right? And there's a spark, and Jesus is like, let's keep, let it burn, baby. Burn, baby, burn. And Jesus is like, just let it burn, Judas. Let it burn. Come on, let's start this relationship. I wanna start a fire in your heart that burns so bright and so strong nobody can ignore it. And Judas, he looks over, sees this. He says, you know what? I kind of like this more. I mean, I've seen some cool stuff, but you know what? If I gotta choose, I gotta make a decision. Well, that's hard. Shh, guys. So Judas, what does he do? He does the same thing a lot of us do. Part of it is ignoring. And then eventually he ignores God. He hardens his heart to God so many times. Refusing to let that spark burn, but eventually he just puts it out. Now listen, guys.
Okay. Video. Please click subscribe. Don't forget to turn on the notification bell to not miss out on my other videos. See you guys later.